Welcome, warrior. We now know that the Beast Lord's lair lies within an underground labyrinth in the region of Mardin. The cannibals have delayed our expansion long enough. Your primary objective is to crush these abominations so the Brotherhood can move on. Our scribes believe that they have found something that might help your mission. They think that the Beast Lords are somehow controlling the monsters and the raiding parties. It is believed that control over the creatures is achieved through some form of symbiosis or possibly even telepathic suggestion. What doesn't add up is how they can control intelligent deathclaws, since the scribe study insists that only creatures of base intelligence would succumb to the controlling force. This leads up to your secondary objective. If we can learn to control these deathclaws and use them to further the cause of the Brotherhood, we could very well expand our region of influence all the way to the West Coast. It is a chance, but not such a great chance that you should jeopardize your first objective. Depart as soon as you assemble your squad. Dismissed! Welcome, warrior. Thank you.
have you come to kill me? Surely you wish to kill the source of the Deathclaw infestation. Kill me and allow my young a chance at freedom. I cannot live another day knowing I am the very collar that holds my children in bondage. You hesitate. Maybe there is another answer. Maybe you can set me free and allow a mother's vengeance. Free me and I will bathe in their leader's blood and feast on his hot, quivering flesh.
Brotherhood of Steel comes to destroy us. We are the animal spirits of this land. You will feed my pets. Yes. Kill them, my beasts. Kill them so I can bathe in their blood. This is how I steal your power. Steal your thoughts.
With the death of the Beast Lord leader, all that remains is to find the source of his control over the Death Claws.
At last! I am free! At last! My children, you are slaves no more! Dar, I will suck the marrow from your bones!
With the death of the Beast Lord leader and the discovery of the Beast Lord's control of the Death Claws, your squad has finished its objectives. Return to your drop-off point for evac.
Fight as if you were from my own brood, warrior. My children are now free due to your selfless act. Thank you for your trust. I have much to think about. I would speak with your leaders after I have gathered my brood around me.
Excellent work, warrior. The beast lords have been eliminated, and the monsters are no longer under their control. News of our victory has already reached the surrounding towns. The Brotherhood's reputation alone will now have new recruits flocking to our front door. Our scribes were correct on the beast lords' relationship with their animal lackeys. The beast lords' inherent telepathic suggestion is a unique ability. It's acquired through prolonged exposure to an unknown radiation present within Mardin's underground caves. Unfortunately, we will not be able to duplicate this feat. The scribes explained that this unique mutation only manifests in humans that have been exposed for at least 20 years. But it is of little matter, since science and discipline will always be victorious over ungodly mutation. These are strange times, warrior. The Deathclaw matriarch spoke to our elders today. It seems that her gratitude is genuine, and that she is allowing some of her spawn to remain behind when her brood moves on. These Deathclaw young are to be treated as honorary initiates to the Order. Plans are already underway to create a special unit to help assimilate these unusual recruits into our ranks. Personally, I have my misgivings towards these dangerous creatures. I do not believe they should be allowed to fight beside our paladins. However, the elders insist on this. Between you and me, brother, sometimes I wonder if the old elders were right. Dismissed.
Hey, thanks, pal. Maybe the master was wrong. Maybe you normal humans ain't all scum-sucking flesh bags, and maybe it's me, but the old Brotherhood would have shot first and asked questions later. We just might have to check out this new Brotherhood for ourselves. See you around. Let's go, Gimpy.
Again, we are victorious, but we cannot rest on our laurels. The time has come again to shift our operations to the new bunker. Take your squad and rendezvous with us there.
Brotherhood's ranks have grown, and with their swollen numbers, they find themselves coming closer to the ultimate goal. The time to expand is now. Leaving an outpost behind, the warriors begin moving westward into a region known as the Belt. It is a scarred and desolate land, filled with death and the relics of a time before. Those who dwell here have scraped together a bleak existence, built on blood and grim determination. These isolated people are as hard as any in the wasteland. Pressuring these people to join the ranks of the Brotherhood will not be easy. Many will not understand the Brotherhood's glorious vision to reunite the people. Some resistance is expected. While the inhabitants are dangerous, the land itself has the power to stir up fearful memories in some of the generals and elders. They tell of the ill-fated flight across the mountains and how their mighty airships were torn apart. Old lore and surviving data suggests that at least one of the Great Brotherhood Zeppelins was lost in this very region. If it were located, there is a chance the equipment and supplies it contained could be salvaged and returned to the noble purpose for which they were intended. There may even be survivors, but few hold any real hope of this. Only time will tell.